Chicago's North Side. We're at Wrigley Field and getting you set for game 162. It's a Hyundai leadoff man on WGN Sports. The Chicago Cubs host the Houston Astros in the Astros' final game in the National League. Hi again, everyone. Welcome to the leadoff man. I'm Len Casper. Overcast skies, but we'll get this thing started on time. We should be just fine weather-wise. The Cubs try to avoid the sweep. They'll play their final game of the season. Lots of guys off the bench will be in the starting lineup today. Starlin Castro will get the start as he'll play in all 162. Coming up, we'll hear from Dale Swaim, Cubs manager, but a reminder, the Hyundai leadoff man brought to you by your Chicago and Northwest Indiana Hyundai dealers. Check out the award-winning Hyundai Sonata at myhyundaichicago.com.
On rules of engagement,
here's your lunch.
If you don't break some rules,
definitely register for this.
You're missing all the fun.
Here's a little secret. Women enjoy sex, too.
That has not been my experience.
Comedy rules.
Sex for chores.
One of those equals two of these.
How about I give you this?
Please, I can do that myself. Right? Okay.
Rules of Engagement. Wednesdays at 8 on WGN America.
This is Rudy. His morning starts with arthritis pain and two pills. Afternoon's overhaul starts with more pain, more pills. Triple checking hydraulics, the evening brings more pain, so back to more pills. Almost done when, hang on, Stan's doctor recommended Aleve. It can keep pain away all day with fewer pills than Tylenol. This is Rudy, a switch to Aleve and two pills for a day free of pain. And get the all-day pain relief of Aleve in liquid gels.
Look, if you have COPD like me, you know it can be hard to breathe and how that feels. COPD includes chronic bronchitis and emphysema. Spiriva helps control my COPD symptoms by keeping my airways open for 24 hours. Plus, it reduces COPD flare-ups. Spiriva is the only once-daily inhaled COPD maintenance treatment that does both.
Spiriva, hand-inhaler tiotropium bromide inhalation powder, does not replace fast-acting inhalers for sudden symptoms. Tell your doctor if you have kidney problems, glaucoma, trouble urinating, or an enlarged prostate. These may worsen with Spiriva. Discuss all medicines you take, even eye drops. Stop taking Spiriva and seek immediate medical help if your breathing suddenly worsens, your throat or tongue swells, you get hives, vision changes or eye pain, or problems passing urine. Other side effects include dry mouth and constipation.
Nothing can reverse COPD. Spiriva helps me breathe better.
Ask your doctor about Spiriva.
The Hyundai leadoff man. Brought to you by your Chicago and Northwest Indiana Hyundai dealers. Check out the award-winning Hyundai Sonata at myhyundaichicago.com.
Well, the final day of the season and the Cub players coming out onto the field about 20 minutes before the first pitch, armed with Major League Baseball, so giving the fans an extra unexpected souvenir here on the final day of the season. Well, Dale Swaim in his first year as a Cubs manager, the record not very good, but gets very high marks for keeping a positive attitude. This coaching staff has worked very hard all season long. He met with the media for the final time for his pregame session today and talked about the value of leadership and who can be a leader in the clubhouse.
I mean, leadership roles are they're not for everybody. Even though it might be the best player on the team, it's not for everybody to be a leader. What you want as a manager is you want 25 guys that are leading by example, and you don't have any issues to where you need a vocal leader. is basically where you want to be at in a 25-man roster. So, but we have some young guys. I think Rizzo's the type of guy that can do that. He's because he leads by example, his work ethic. He's got a chance of being both. In all my years, people talk about leaders. In all my years, you really don't come across that prototypical vocal lead by example type guy. A lot of guys just don't have that in them to be able to concentrate on their game and then to worry about the other 24 guys as well.
Dale, can Castro mature himself into an MVP player?
Well, he's got all the ability to do a lot of things. That's you know, probably the key word is mature as he goes forward. You know, he's very young. He's 22. He's already played 3 years in the big leagues. You know, so those are kind of the next steps. You know, like I just said about, you know, the pitch selections, the focus on an everyday basis, on an every pitch basis. You know, once that gets, you know, to a higher level, then he'll have a, you know, opportunity to bring a lot more to the table.
Did signing the contract actually improve his focus, you think?
You know, I don't know if I see anything different that way, but the best thing about it, signing the contract, is I haven't seen him go backwards. You know, I've seen him actually go forward. I see a guy that cares still. You know, he's had good at bats with men in scoring position. You know, that's the biggest thing, that since he signed that contract, I've seen him, you know, go forward instead of backwards.
People who watch Cub games on TV and see you that remark, gosh, the poor guy's going through hell. How can he possibly have fun? Have you had fun this year in some degree?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I've been in the game 30 years and I enjoy coming to the ballpark. I enjoy, now it's obviously managing. I enjoyed coaching. I enjoy, you know, the competitiveness of everything about it. I, you know, enjoy, you know, watching the guys work, improve. You know, so it's part of my life. But yeah, I mean, I have fun doing it. I mean, when the game's over with, just like anything, nobody likes losing. You know, that's part of life as well. And you know, somebody's got to win, somebody's got to lose. You don't want to lose 102 games. You know, nobody said life was easy either.
That's Cubs manager Dale Swayman. We want to tell fans about a great event coming up on December 9th in Parkland, Florida. That's South Florida, where Anthony Rizzo is from. It's the inaugural walk-off for cancer. Anthony is a cancer survivor. For more information, if you want to participate or donate to the cause, it's Rizzo44.com. Rizzo44.com. And Anthony told me they are looking to have an event in Chicago coming up next summer. Coming up next, we'll go around baseball and take a look at the pennant races here on the final day of the season. Next.
How much does it cost to cut an energy bill down to size? Or get the yard ready for cool weather? The answer? A lot less. The Great American Fix-Up is going on now, with new projects every week and big savings every day. So you can do what needs to be done today. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Right now, Owens Corning EcoTouch Attic Insulation is only $11.87 a roll.
Hey, cool, I won.
Oh, Monopoly is so awesome.
One in four are winners. It's tough to beat those odds.
I can. I ordered a leprechaun to help me win.
Okay, but you do know the odds are still one in four.
Yo,
right?
Who ordered the leprechaun?
It's a giant.
No one ordered a leprechaun? That's weird.
It's the 20th edition of Monopoly at McDonald's, and one in four wins. With over 135 million winning game pieces, it's the most prizes ever. The simple joy of winning.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card gives you a 50% annual bonus, and everyone likes 50% more
rubles.
50% more simoleons.
50% more sawbucks.
50% more clams. It's a lobster, either way.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card. With a 50% annual cash bonus, it's the card for people who like more cash.
50% more dough. What's in your wallet?
Can I have everyone's attention, please?
Everyone, if I may direct your attention to the television.
WGN.
WGN.
WGN. WGN America.
WGN America.
Where the fans are in charge. This is WGN America, home to the biggest shows on television.
The biggest shows on TV.
Nice. Looks like WGN America filled out in all the right places.
I want to go to there.
You're good, WGN America. You're very good.
The Hyundai Leadoff Man, brought to you by your Chicago and Northwest Indiana Hyundai dealers. Check out the award-winning Hyundai Sonata at myhyundaichicago.com.
Let's go first to third. Still some things to be decided. How about the West in the American League? Former Cub Ryan Dempster against rookie right-hander A.J. Griffin. The winner takes a West. The loser will be in the wild card one-game playoff. Also, New York and Baltimore. You've got the Yankees up by a game, so if they win, they take the East. And the Cardinals are in as they win that second wild card. They'll play at Atlanta later this week. We'll have Cubs baseball from Wrigley Field. Final day of the season coming up.
At Mobil, we believe it's smarter to change your oil than change your car. We believe in friends that go the extra mile, and engines that go the extra years. We believe your engine should last till this little one has little ones of her own. That's why we created Mobil Super, tested and proven to help reduce wear, prevent sludge, and extend the life of your engine for the long, long run. Mobil Super, for long engine life.
If you use catheters, I have some great news. You will never have to reuse catheters again. Medicare and most private insurance now cover up to $200 a month. That means you can use a new sterile catheter every time you cath. And these new catheters, they're softer, they're more gentle, and they're much easier to use. So call Comfort Medical today. They make it simple. They bill Medicare and private insurance directly. There are no upfront costs, and they deliver your supplies right to your door for free.
Call 1-800-853-9093 now, and Comfort Medical will send you free samples of these new gentle catheters. And if you call 1-800-853-9093 today, Comfort Medical will also send you a free comfort kit. Call 1-800-853-9093 now. Operators are standing by.
Call Comfort Medical today. You'll be glad you did.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch.
Do you want it? You want it? No?
Come and get it!
Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
When it comes to home video, an epic fail is a huge success. A successful night starts at 7 with America's funniest home videos on WGN America.
The following is a sports presentation of WGN America.
For the final time here in 2012, we're set for Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN Sports. The Astros and Cubs wrap up the season, and we welcome Cub fans from all over the country watching on WGN America, America's home for baseball. Great to have you with us, Bob Brenly and Len Casper with you. It's been a tough year for the Cubs, but Bob, I think you can look at today in two ways. A lot of people are ready to move on and look ahead to 2013, but because of the change that is inevitable in baseball, a little sadness that the season is ending because it was a pretty tight clubhouse.
Yeah, it really was. I mean, for all the things that went wrong on the field, a lot of things went right behind the scenes, and I think the Cubs are in a good place. It's hard to say that after a 100-loss season, but I think they've got some guys in position now moving forward. Not only on the field, but within the organization, and I think the future is going to be very bright.
Right-hander Edgar Gonzalez for the Astros, left-hander Travis Wood for the Cubs, and now down to the field for our national anthem.
See at the Lowry Organ as they honor America with our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner
with our national anthem. Nice gesture as the Cubs came out before the game to hand some souvenirs to the Cub fans. We'll have the final game of the season coming up. Astros and Cubs are next.
Your attention to the television.
WGN.
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 WGN America.
WGN America.
Where the fans are in charge. This is WGN America, home to the biggest shows on television.
The biggest shows on TV.
Nice. Looks like WGN America filled out in all the right places.
I want to go to there.
You're good, WGN America. You're very good.
Happy couple used Capital One Venture Miles for their destination wedding.
Double miles you can actually use.
But with those single mile travel cards.
Blacked out, but I'm a bridesmaid.
X marks the spot she'll never sit.
But I bought a dress.
A toast.
To the Capital One Venture card. Fly any airline, any flight, anytime.
Double miles you can actually use.
What a coincidence. What's in your wallet? Watch the elbows, ladies.
I have unlocked a secret.
Critics are spellbound by the master. Joaquin Phoenix and Philip Seymour Hoffman are electrifying. Amy Adams is superb. The best movie I've seen all year.
Calm down, no!
The Master, rated R.
Do not fall asleep at a sleepover. Lesson learned.
He needs rest.
Long day of childhood calls for America's favorite pasta sauce.
Chicago Cubs baseball brought to you by Budweiser. Great times are waiting. Grab some Buds. Pepsi Max, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste. The Illinois Lottery. Do you believe in the power of possibility? The Illinois Lottery. Anything's possible. And by Ford, manufacturers of more fuel-efficient vehicles than any other brand. Check them out at your local Ford store or online at localfordstores.com. Chicago Cubs baseball in high definition is brought to you by Xfinity, your home for the most live sports. Finals Astros lineup of the season. They're trying to avoid setting a new record for single season losses. Tyler Green's going to be at second in for Jose Altuve. Jed Lowry at short. Matt Dominguez at third. Justin Maxwell plays left. Carlos Corporan back of the plate. Brandon Barnes in center. Brandon Laird at first. Jimmy Paredes in right. And Edgar Gonzalez, the pitcher.
Let's check out how the Cubs take the field defensively today behind Travis Wood, brought to you by Pepsi Max, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste. Campana, Jackson, and Sapelt left to right across the outfield. Vitters, Castro, Cardenas, and LaHare third to first across the infield. Anthony Recker doing the catching today for left-hander Travis Wood.
And we're ready to go as Tyler Green takes ball one. The Astros with back-to-back 3-0 wins to start this series. As you get a look at Travis Wood's 2012 season, his first as a Cub. Fly ball to right. Dave Sapelt is out there. And that's out number one. Southside Chicago native John Tumpain behind the plate. Jim Wolf's at first. Ron Culp at second. And the crew chief Wally Bell over third.
Hey, Len, we want to alert the fans before we get too deep into this ball game. Don't be surprised if you see Travis Wood flip a knuckleball up there to the plate today. Talking to Chris Bosio down in the coach's room before the game, and he alerted me that Travis has been kind of playing around with the pitch a little bit, and what better time to break it out than game 162. So we may see a knuckleball or two from Travis Wood today.
Jed Lowry is switch hitter. One ball, one strike. And low that time. Cubs with two guys in the lineup who came over in the Sean Marshall trade in the offseason, Travis Wood and Dave Sapelt. Also got a minor league infielder in that deal, Ronnie Torres. Cubs starters have done okay in this series. Chris Volstad last night, 7 innings, 1 earned run as Lowry takes the walk. Jason Birkin, 2 runs and 4 2/3, but no run support. Pleasant, 67 degrees, and the wind actually slightly blowing out towards center. We had some drizzle earlier this morning, and it still is overcast, but while the grounds are a bit wet, it is not raining.
Yeah, the infield's in great shape, obviously covered by the tarp all night and through the early part of the morning, but the outfield could be a little soggy out there in some spots.
One strike to Matt Dominguez. About two, Cardenas to Castro, no relay throw. Looked like Adrian just kind of stumbled a little bit, which threw off the timing, so two outs on the fielder's choice.
Right, double plays are all about rhythm and timing, as you said, and when Cardenas kind of lost his balance a little bit, just kind of threw off the rhythm of the play. Looked like Castro caught that ball way up in the webbing of his glove and wasn't able to dig it out in time to make the relay throw on to first base.
Swing and a miss on a changeup. It's Justin Maxwell. He's playing left, but based on what we saw last night and what the Astros have done over the past couple of weeks, he may play all three spots today in the outfield. Started in center last night and went to right and finished in left.
Time to look at today's Mazda drive to victory. What the Cubs need to do today is have some fun. We've already lost 100 ball games on this season. You got the killer bees out there. I want to see Tony Campana hit a ball out of the ballpark. I want to see Brian LaHare steal a base. I want to see Travis Wood throw the knuckleball. Have some fun. Drive to Victory brought to you by your local Chicagoland Mazda dealer. See your Chicagoland Mazda dealer for a test drive today at driveamazda.com.
One and two on Maxwell. Dominguez the runner at first, just underway. Astros playing their final game ever as a National League club, finishing up their 51st season. And interestingly enough, they have 3,999 wins all time. So they're shooting for number 4,000 before they move to the American League West. They're also finishing strong. This will be their only winning road trip of the season. They've already won four of the first five, took two of three at Milwaukee over the weekend, and have won the first two of this series. Even though they are 4-1 on this trip, they have 60 road losses. Ball four, second walk of the inning. And Bob, it's not as if they're joining a division where you can say, oh, that'll be a piece of cake. The American League West.
Yeah, I mean, there are going to be adjustments going to the American League to begin with. Different style of play. You're going to have to find a DH somewhere, but I don't think those teams are going to wait for the Astros to get up to speed. They're going to have to hit the ground running in the AL.
The second of three switch hitters in the Astros lineup, Carlos Corporan, the catcher. And he takes a pitch inside for ball one on a cutter.
See, four home runs on the season for Corporan, all coming from the left side of the plate, only a 200 hitter from the right side.
Fouled into the upper deck off of first base. Oh, what a nice gesture by the Cubs before the game as they came out all with a bag of probably a half a dozen baseballs each. Tossed them into the seats. So a lot of fans going home with a souvenir as Anthony Rizzo and David DeJesus talk about their next manicure appointment.
Yeah, this is a one day a year, Len, that Cubs players don't mind throwing the ball in the stands.
Darwin Barney brought out the lineup card. See a lot of boxes and tape.
Yep.
In the clubhouses. Very busy. The manager's door was closed most of the morning as he met individually with his players.
Yeah, lots of baby strollers and car seats and children's toys that found their way here to Chicago for the summer, headed back home, wherever home may be.
Base hit in the left center, and the Astros will get an early lead as Dominguez will come around to score. Throw to third is late. On the play, Corporan takes second.
Yeah, a lot of mistakes on this particular play. Should never throw Carlos Corporan an off-speed pitch. He was having trouble catching up to an 88-mile-an-hour heater. You speed up his bat by throwing that breaking ball. Tony Campana needs to throw that ball to second base rather than third base. But as it is, the Astros are on the board with two men in scoring position.
It'll bring up Brandon Barnes, the center fielder. So those two walks coming back to haunt Travis Wood. Astros last in the majors in runs. But they've been hitting home runs lately and have come up with some timely hits here in this series. It's just their 580th run of the year. This will be the final game for Tony DeFrancesco as the Astros manager. Bo Porter recently hired last Thursday, and he will take over next season, will officially join the organization after the Washington Nationals finish their postseason. He's their third base coach. Could either be at the end of October or next week. Who knows?
It would only be human nature. I mean, of course, Bo Porter is going to do everything he can to help the Nationals get deep into the postseason, but I'm sure he's already started to look at potential rosters for next season and try to see how this Astros organization fits together, checking out some of the minor league numbers of their prospects, just to try to get a leg up before he jumps into it full speed.
DeFrancesco expected to remain in the Astros organization in some capacity. That's a strike on the outside, and then it's 3-2.
Paints that outside corner, a little bit of a cutter working its way back, just does nip the outside corner.
Fly to right, Sepelt coming over near the line, the slide, and he's got it. And that'll end the inning. Nicely done by Dave Sepelt. Astros get one. The Cubs are coming up.
Little things still get you. For you, life's about her. But your erectile dysfunction, that could be a question of blood flow. Cialis Tadalafil for daily use helps you be ready anytime the moment's right. You can be more confident in your ability to be ready. And the same Cialis is the only daily ED tablet approved to treat ED and symptoms of BPH, like needing to go frequently or urgently. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions and medications and ask if your heart is healthy enough for sexual activity. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Do not drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease or loss in hearing or vision, or if you have any allergic reactions such as rash, hives, swelling of the lips, tongue, or throat, or difficulty breathing or swallowing, stop taking Cialis and get medical help right away. Ask your doctor about Cialis for daily use and a 30-tablet free trial.
Now Dale Swaim's Pepsi lineup brought to you by Pepsi Max, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste. Tony Campana needs a stolen base. He's sitting on 29 for the year. Cardenas at second. Starlin Castro's played in every game this season. Brian LeHair in for Rizzo. Dave Sepelt in right. Josh Vitters and Brett Jackson, the rookies, are in the lineup today. Anthony Recker, the catcher, and Travis Wood, who does a good job with the bat.
And here's how the Astros will line it up defensively at Wrigley Field this afternoon. Justin Maxwell, Brandon Barnes, Jimmy Paredes left to right across the outfield. Matt Dominguez and Jed Lowry on the left side of the infield. Tyler Green and Brandon Laird on the right side. Carlos Corporan doing the catching today for right-hander Edgar Gonzalez.
You remember him.
Yeah, he helped put me in the booth.
Really?
10 starts for the 04 Diamondbacks went 0-9. That put me in the booth.
So I have him to thank.
Yeah, one of many.
Well, he's been okay for the Astros. They actually signed him out of the Mexican League. He's from Monterrey, Mexico. He began the year as a non-roster invitee with the Oakland A's and was released in spring training. Pitched at AAA for the Colorado Springs Sky Sox, was released in June, and then went back home and made 6 starts in Mexico. Campana on the ground, surrounded by Tyler Green, and he got him by half a step.
Hey, you're liable to see a lot of different pitches from Edgar Gonzalez today. He sinks his fastball, he cuts it, he throws a curve, a slide, or a changeup.
has played around with the splitter in the past, as you see Campana narrowly thrown out at first base. And he just kind of invents things as he goes along out there, depending on the situation.
One and nothing on second baseman Adrian Cardenas. Well, wind blowing out. You see Cardenas without a home run. See if he can hit the first of his career before the season ends. Change up just outside.
Yeah, get a look at our Xfinity pitch tracks. We want to thank Dave Abbott, Keith Glob, Nick Pinto, and Ben Stash for their fine work this year, providing us with the pitch tracks and allowing me to get on the umpires on a regular basis. So thank you very much, guys.
Gonzalez working quickly and inside on a fastball as he walks Cardenas. We have big news around baseball today, partner.
Mm-hmm.
Teddy Roosevelt won the president's race for the first time.
Get out.
Yeah.
Wow.
So the Nationals win the division, and Teddy finally won the president's race at Nationals Park.
Well, I don't know what's bigger news in D.C. Teddy had had a real rough run of races there in D.C., but finally broke through. Nice going.
And nice going, Starlin Castro. He played in every game. Only missed one start, but even got into that contest. So he is the first Cubs shortstop ever to play in all 162. He sees among the leaders in the National League in singles. He has set career highs in home runs with 14, RBIs 78, 12 triples, 25 stolen bases. First player in the National League in 5 years to have at least 10 homers, 10 triples, 25 steals, and 75 RBIs. Let's take a look at today's Illinois Lottery Anything's Possible player. It is Starlin Castro, first Cub infielder to play in every game since Ron Santo in 1968. The Anything's Possible player is brought to you by the Illinois Lottery, who each day make anything possible. On the ground to the shortstop, Lowry. They get one, they get two. 6-4-3, and the Cubs finished in the first. They trail 1-0.
Yes, I can. Doubt better leave. I'm running with this plan. Pull me, grab me, grab me in a bucket, can't have me. I'll be the president.
They landed on the tribute of your move.
Oh, you like that guy? Like you the one drinking what God said. I got a word for the tongue. How many rolling stones you want? Yeah, I got a brand new spirit speaking and it's done. Woke up on the side of the bed like I won. Talk like the winner majestic that's on. G5 in the U.S. to Taiwan. Now who can say that? I want to play back. I got a feeling it's a rap. It's back.
This happy couple used Capital One Venture Miles for their destination wedding.
Double miles you can actually use.
But with those single mile travel cards.
Blacked out, but I'm a bridesmaid.
X marks the spot she'll never sit.
But I bought a dress.
A toast.
To the Capital One Venture Card. Fly any airline, any flight, any time.
Double miles you can actually use. What a coincidence.
What's in your wallet? Watch the elbows, ladies.
Now at Joseph A. Bank, all suits and sport coats are buy one, get two free. Every suit and sport coat, even our new slim fit suits, all buy one, get two more absolutely free. Right now at Joseph A. Bank.
What I want, you got, it might be hard to handle. Like a flame that burns a candle. A candle feeds a flame. And what I got, full stock of thoughts and dreams.
Imagine if your heart could be free to find exactly what it's looking for. eHarmony gets to know you better to match you better. Start today free.
Your favorite comedies, sports, and movies, all on WGN America.
Second inning, Astros leading 1-0. Brandon Laird, the first baseman, and younger brother of Tiger catcher Gerald Laird. Oh, amen. We say that all the time about our jobs.
Absolutely.
On a bounce to Josh Vitters.
Hey, we want to let our AT&T UVerse viewers in Chicago and around the country on WGN America know that during every Cubs home game this season, if you go to channel 780 or high def channel 1780, you can see a special multi-view presentation that shows you all of our different live camera angles right here at Wrigley Field. It's pretty cool, so if you want to direct the game along with Skip Ellison, give a look to AT&T UVerse channel 780 or high def channel 1780.
Switch hitting right fielder Jimmy Paredes converted from second base to the outfield in the middle of the year at AAA. He was a Pacific Coast League All-Star. And he chops one foul. One ball, one strike. We will see the Astros here next year as part of interleague play. Cubs will play the entire American League West, including home and home with the Angels. The 2013 season will open on April 1st at Pittsburgh, and the next game here at Wrigley Field will be Monday, April 8th. Against the Milwaukee Brewers. Brewers, Giants, and Texas Rangers come in on that first homestand. That's right, interleague play all year because of 15-team leagues. And he got him. That's Wood's first strikeout. And let's take a look at our Ford upcoming Cubs schedule. Cubs at Pirates and Braves to start the season, and then we mentioned the long homestand beginning on April 8th. Ford, manufacturers of more fuel-efficient vehicles than any other brand. Check them out at your local Ford store or online at localfordstores.com.
Now his busy season is about to get started here pretty soon. Enjoying his last day of summer vacation.
I think he just flew in for the day. Making the rounds here.
Probably not commercial either.
Three and oh on the pitcher Gonzalez. I've been told that the logos spell my lovely wife Pam's name.
Very
P-A-M.
Nice.
Nice of the Cubs to do that. As Gonzalez walks. I like it. They've been waiting all year to break that one out on me. Final day. Well, one thing. I know the pitching staff's got to improve on next year. I'm sure Chris Bosio's put it in his notebook. Don't walk the pitcher. Happened way too often this season.
Yep. I mean, there aren't many Travis Woods out there. Guys that can really swing the bat out of that nine spot.
Better hurry. Hey. Safe. Green's speed buys him a two out hit.
The dreaded swinging bunt, take a full hack and just top the ball down the third base side. Josh Vitters was playing deep with two outs in the inning and just couldn't get it across quickly enough for the out. Nice barehanded pickup, but as you said, Tyler Green runs extremely well.
Lowry walked his first time, late swing and a foul strike.
Now this is what happens when you walk the pitcher in that nine spot. You roll around to the top of the order where you do have some guys that can swing the bat. I don't care what lineup you're talking about. You'd much rather bear down on those guys in the 7, 8, 9 spots and be a little more careful with the guys in the 1, 2, 3 spot. But when you put that pitcher on base, paves the way for bad things to happen.
Travis Wood, just 25 years old, born in Little Rock, Arkansas. And as we mentioned, came over from the Reds over the winters. He'll talk it over with his catcher, Anthony Recker. We'd love to hear from you here on this final day of the 2012 season. You can email us, LennonBob@Tribune.com. And also follow us on Facebook and Twitter. And a few shout outs today as well. We better get him in today. We're going to have to wait 6 months. Nice play by Wood. That'll end the inning as the Astros lead 2. Bottom 2, 1-0 for the visitors.
On rules of engagement,
here's your lunch.
If you don't break some rules,
definitely register for this.
You're missing all the fun.
Here's a little secret. Women enjoy sex, too.
That has not been my experience.
Comedy rules.
Sex for chores. One of those equals two of these.
How about I give you this?
Please, I can do that myself. Right? Okay.
Rules of Engagement. Wednesdays at 8 on WGN America.
In the neighborhood,
there's a hardware store
with a familiar face.
Like this.
Like this.
Like this.
We're all different,
but we're all the same.
Because we're all experts. So next time
you have a question, ask us.
Your local
True Value Hardwareians.
For all the right tools,
products, and local advice.
True Value.
Start right. Start here.
Right now, we've got everything you need for that all-important fall cleanup. So hurry in today.
Do not fall asleep at a sleepover. Lesson learned.
He needs ragu.
Long day of childhood calls for America's favorite pasta sauce.
Now at Joseph A. Bank, all suits and sport coats are buy one, get two free. Every suit and sport coat, even our new slim fit suits, all buy one, get two more absolutely free. Right now at Joseph A. Bank.
Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl is back. Endless combinations of pasta and sauce for just $9.95. Plus, all the unlimited crisp salad or homemade soup and warm breadsticks you want. The pasta never ends, but the offer does. Only at Olive Garden.
Your favorite comedies, sports, and movies, all on WGN America.
Time now to take a look at our Xfinity catcher profile. Protecting home for the Brooklyn Robins, the Reds, the Braves, the New York Giants, Ernie Lombardi. Schnoz. 306 career average, hit 190 homers, 8-time All-Star, a world champ back in 1940, was the National League MVP in 1938, inducted into the National Baseball Hall of Fame in 1986, won a couple of batting titles. And people who have studied the history of the game say that might have been the most incredible accomplishment. The fact that Ernie Lombardi could win a batting title, they say he was the slowest human being to walk on the planet. Never got an infield hit. Xfinity Home offers state-of-the-art features that help you stay connected to your home and family anytime and anywhere.
Ryan LaHare leading off the second, and he takes a strike. LaHare was an all-star, a first baseman at the time before Anthony Rizzo came up. And he hits that one deep to left toward the bleachers. Gone. Number 16 for Brian LaHare to tie the game. And the Cubs finally get on the board in the series. It's his first since August 22nd.
Boy, and by far the best contact we've seen from Brian LaHare since his last home run. That pitch is off the plate away, just drives it out there to straightaway left field. That's the swing we saw in the first half of the season that earned him that All-Star berth.
This is only his 10th start since August 5th, which is when Brett Jackson and Josh Vitters came up to the big leagues. And with Jackson going to center, to Jesus and right, that put LaHare basically on the bench. One and one on Dave Sapelt. So the Astros will not have four consecutive shutouts. The three in a row, the first time they had done that since the 1986 season. Jim Deshaies, Nolan Ryan, and Mike Scott, who pitched a no-hitter against the Giants to clinch the National League West.
I will take no blame for that no-hitter. I wasn't in the lineup that day. It's all Bob Melvin's fault.
The wind in the 1-2. Fly well hit to right. And Paredes makes a grab for the out. So we try to tie it all together. Catchers winning batting titles. Bubbles Hargrave back in 1926. Joe Mauer with three of them in the American League. And Buster Posey's might need an asterisk. His teammate Melky Cabrera hit 346. Posey right now at 337. But Cabrera not eligible after he and baseball and the union agreed don't take his name out of it because of the PED suspension.
Just a remarkable accomplishment for any catcher to finish with that high of a batting average. Obviously Buster Posey and Yadier Molina, Carlos Ruiz from the Phillies, guys that are among the league leaders every year, and the physical demands of that position. It's just remarkable that they're able to maintain their offensive level of excellence with the daily beating they take behind the plate.
Ball four, Vitters takes a one out walk. Got a birthday wish. Matt Johnson, the Cubs assistant athletic trainer, wants to send a happy birthday to his mom Cheryl watching in LaGrange Park this afternoon.
Yeah, we're going to say Cheryl's just celebrating the anniversary of her 25th birthday.
Right.
We won't say what anniversary.
Also, happy 8th birthday to Mackenzie Millard. Four generations of Cub fans will be watching today, along with Mackenzie, including her dad, Steve. Two on Jackson. Two other games going on. Braves leading the Pirates 4-0. Ben Sheets started that game, and in the final game of his career, he had already announced prior that he would retire. A 1-2-3 first inning. And according to Jim Powell, the fine radio broadcaster, he threw 10 fastballs out of his 12 pitches, maxed out at 96 miles an hour. It's a way to go out on top for Ben Sheets. That game in Pittsburgh's in the top of the eighth. Braves leading. They will host St. Louis in the wild card game later this week. That's the only actual matchup we know of right now, believe it or not. Hey, fans, coming up in December, Anthony Rizzo is going to be hosting the inaugural Walk-Off for Cancer in Parkland, Florida. That's in South Florida, just north of Miami. Go to Rizzo44.com. It's a 5K walk hosted by the Anthony Rizzo Family Foundation. Go to that website if you'd like to donate to the cause, and Anthony is planning on having an event in Chicago next year. As Jackson fouls off, we'll do another 3-2 coming up.
I mentioned it yesterday, Len. It's really good to see Anthony Rizzo and some of the other young Cubs starting to get involved in various charities, whether it's their own family foundation or a charity that's close to their heart. Somebody in their family has been afflicted by a disease or whatever it is. You really love to see that from the young players, and they've taken their cue from the veterans on this Cubs teams. A lot of guys deeply involved, especially here in the Chicago area.
Edgar Gonzalez, 29 years old, gets the swing and miss. Vitters, however, safe at second to keep the inning alive. And let's step aside and see what's coming up on WGN.
When you think mother, think America. How I Met Your Mother. Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays starting at 8 East, 5 West, right here on WGN America.
Second career steal for Josh Vitters. It's interesting you kind of lose track of a guy like Edgar Gonzalez when you realize he's not even 30 yet.
And when he started with the Diamondbacks, I believe he was the youngest player in the major leagues back in 03.
He would have been 20. One relief appearance for the Rockies last year. Prior to that, hadn't pitched since 2009 with Oakland. These two guys were in spring training together. Anthony Recker actually made the A's opening day roster. I'm sure both will be keeping an eye on what happens later today with the Rangers and the A's. There is another Edgar Gonzalez, and he was with the Cubs in spring training. He is the brother of Adrian Gonzalez. And he's an infielder. I've got a note on Gonzalez on his 2004 season. You might want to cover your ears for it. You mentioned the 0-9 and 10 starts.
Mm-hmm.
He was a fourth pitcher since 1946. To go winless over an entire season with at least 9 losses. Now this was after you were no longer his manager at this point.
Yeah.
But on September 3rd of that year at San Francisco, he went one inning, gave up 10 runs on 8 hits. One inning. You need a lot of humility after a night like that, a lot of confidence in yourself to bounce back from a start like that. Ooh.
Well, as a 20-year-old, he had a great arm. He still has a good arm. Heavy sinking fastball in the low 90s. Occasionally will struggle with his command. Occasionally will give up the long ball. And as his career has progressed, he's incorporated more pitches. I think he might have been better when he just had 2.
sharply hit ground ball. Gobbled up by Tyler Green. Leadoff homer, Brian LaHare to tie it up. 1-1 after two.
Every film director knows you have to go through a little pain to get the shot. America's Funniest Home Videos, weeknights at 7 on WGN America.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch. Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
When you get heartburn, it's too late for Prilosec. It takes at least 24 hours for full effect. But it's never too late for Zantac. Its fast-release acid blockers relieve heartburn in as little as 30 minutes. No pill works faster. When heartburn strikes, try Zantac.
This is Rudy. His morning starts with arthritis pain and two pills. Afternoon's overhaul starts with more pain, more pills. Triple checking hydraulics, the evening brings more pain, so back to more pills. Almost done when, hang on, Stan's doctor recommended Aleve. It can keep pain away all day with fewer pills than Tylenol. This is Rudy, who switched to Aleve and two pills for a day free of pain.
And try Aleve for relief from tough headaches.
Do not fall asleep at a sleepover. Lesson learned.
He needs Ragu.
A long day of childhood calls for America's favorite pasta sauce.
Time out to take a look at our AT&T U-verse replay of the game. There was the D'Agostino's pizza before Bob totally devoured it. We had a nice meal with our wonderful WGN sports crew.
Thanks, Bob.
Funny, Paula.
Yeah.
Funny.
Okay, Paula.
See what's possible with AT&T U-verse high-speed internet. AT&T rethink possible. Our stage manager, Paula Ostrova, wondering who we are. And we always like to embarrass her.
You. You're in trouble.
I think one day she should host the leadoff, man.
Absolutely.
Wouldn't that be fun? And she just left.
I'll tell you what. Pizza for breakfast before a ball game, it doesn't get much better than that. I'm telling you. And the weather so far has cooperated. Had some misty rain this morning. Gray overcast.
We even had a Hall of Famer stop by during lunch. Billy Williams dropped by. That's going to drop foul for Dominguez.
Hey, Cubs fans, if you want to manage a game along with Dale Swaim, log on to WGNTV.com right now and click on the WGN Sports Game Zone banner to connect to all the up-to-the-minute stats and information while you're watching at home. Game Zone is sponsored by The Great Escape. Pools, patio sets, play sets, hot tubs, and more.
Club deep to left and foul. So we go to the final day. And in the American League, the Yankees, the Orioles, the A's, and the Rangers all still could win a division title, but none has to this point. You still have the best record in the National League to be determined, as the Nationals and the Reds are tied at 97-64. The Nationals would win the tiebreaker, so if they hold on to their 3-1 lead over the Phillies in the sixth, they will get home field advantage throughout. The Orioles need a Yankees loss, and the Orioles need to win at Tampa Bay. to force a playoff to determine the East champion. The loser would be a wild card team. How about Raul Ibanez? He entered the game as a pinch hitter in the ninth against the Red Sox last night, hit a home run to tie it, and then won it on an RBI single in the 12th.
That's a good day.
Back to the pitcher Wood.
Well, the Dodgers have to be wondering what if this morning. Base running mistake late in the ball game probably cost them the tying run in the game against the Giants. Giants held on for a 4-3 victory, eliminating the Dodgers from that second wild card race.
Maxwell pummels one into the gap, bangs it off the door on his way to second. The throw goes there, nobody covering. Now the fans are booing here, but I would say in Adrian Cardenas's defense, and you can tell me where he should have been, the carom of that ball actually made that a potential play at second base. It looked like it might be a triple at first.
Yeah, most of the time a ball hit into the gap that rolls up against the fence, forcing the outfielder to go all the way to the vines to get it. That's an easy double. You line up your cut to third base, but that ball rocketed back off the vines. And really, that is Brian LaHare's responsibility to be at second base on that play. Once you see the double cut set up by the shortstop and second baseman, first baseman has no responsibilities at first, so he's supposed to trail the runner into second.
That one is going to hold up for Sapelt as Corporon lines out two away.
Well, that ball was smoked off the bat of Justin Maxwell, one of the harder line drives we've seen this season. Hit about halfway up the wall and shot back toward the infield. Fortunately, didn't get. Well, this is the ball to right field. Another nice running catch by Dave Sapelt, getting a real good jump out there on that tailing sinking line drive.
To third, Vitters. Not a great throw, but LaHare able to stretch and make the play. Astros strand one. It's tied at one.
The perfect shot starts with loved ones and ends with a bang. Make tonight a hit. America's Funniest Home Video starts at 7 on WGN America.
Capital One Cash Rewards card gives you a 50% annual bonus, and everyone but her likes 50% more cash. But I have an idea.
Do you want a princess dress?
Yeah.
How about some cupcakes?
Yeah.
Lollipop?
Yeah.
Do you want an Etch-a-Sketch?
Yeah.
Do you want 50% more cash?
Nope.
You got talent.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card. With a 50% annual cash bonus, it's the card for people who like more cash.
What's your wallet?
I usually say that.
I have unlocked a secret.
Critics are spellbound by the master. Joaquin Phoenix and Philip Seymour Hoffman are electrifying. Amy Adams is superb. The best movie I've seen all year.
Calm down, no!
The Master, rated R.
When you get heartburn, it's too late for Prilosec. It takes at least 24 hours for full effect.
But it's never too late for Zantac. Its fast-release acid blockers relieve heartburn in as little as 30 minutes. No pill works faster. When heartburn strikes, try Zantac.
Your favorite comedies, sports, and movies, all on WGN America.
Back to throw. Hits into the very back of the left field fan. The Giants win the pennant.
Today's game is brought to you by Budweiser. This year, Budweiser will donate $5,000 for every Cubs walk-off win to Folds of Honor. Find us at Facebook.com/Budweiser to see how you can help support our nation's soldiers and veterans.
Russ Hodges with that great call as Travis Wood thumps to left. It's caught by Maxwell. So a hard hit out. We're tied at one here in the bottom of the third.
Bobby Thompson home run coming into game three of the National League playoffs back in 1951.
Well, Tony's got to find a way to get on base and attempt his to get his 30th steal. Takes a strike. Gonzalez comes back on a 1-1. He thought it was a good pitch. John Tumpain did not.
Yeah, Tony with a nice job of laying off the high changeup on the pitch before, but then comes right back to chase a high fastball. That's one of the things you'd like to see Tony change in his approach offensively. Lay off those pitches at the top of the zone. Chances are they're going to result in a fly ball, and that's not what he wants to do. Look for pitches down, hit them on the ground, use that speed.
Well, the Indians need a new manager next year. Sandy Alomar Jr. finishing the year as a skipper after Manny Acta was let go. He will interview formally tomorrow. Terry Francona will interview on Friday as Campana is aboard. Infield single for Campana. I don't know if he's going to be safe at second, but I bet the world he's going to try to run.
Oh, yeah. Tyler Green has to go a couple steps to his right. A tricky hop gets back into the heel of his glove, drops harmlessly on the infield, and Tony Campana will now start his engine. Corporon behind the plate, 5 out of 18 on the season, 5 caught stealing in 18 attempts. That's about 28% success rate.
And they pitch out.
We don't run on pitch outs. That's what somebody from the Cubs dugout is probably yelling out at the field right now. That's a common thing to happen in the game when a speedy runner gets on first base and the other team pitches out. We don't run on pitch outs.
They're going to get him. Ooh, he got back as he was leaning. Took a stutter step towards second and somehow was able to get back in time.
Ooh, very close.
Meanwhile, 2-0. Bob, we got invited to a wedding.
Really?
On December 1st in Indianapolis, Indiana. We will be unable to make it, but we want to wish Jessica Gully and Jeffrey Galbraith the very best.
Absolutely.
On.
And Jeffrey, quite possibly for the last time in the 2012 season, I will offer this little tidbit of advice. You're going to need to practice this phrase and use it often. Yes, dear, you're right. I'm sorry.
Campana will head to second. And he'll stop there, throwing error by the pitcher Gonzalez.
Speed changes everything. Tony Campana got on base, and immediately the Astros' attention was focused on him. Gonzalez fell behind 2-0 to the hitter at the plate. An errant pickoff attempt at first, and Campana into scoring position. Changes everything. You saw Tony take that big turn and slip a little bit as he hit the brakes, rounding second base, but there were no Astro defenders close to him. Tyler Green, the second baseman, was also pursuing the overthrow into foul territory, and the shortstop Jed Lowry moved into a cutoff position, so there was nobody defensively near second base. That's why he could take that aggressive turn around second and hope for another bad throw.
Curve for a strike.
Did I mention speed changes everything?
You did.
Well, it's like having a pebble in your shoe. You know it's there and it's bothering the living daylights out of you. You don't know how to, you try to bang your heel on the ground just to move it a little bit until you can take your shoe off. Tony Campana is a pebble in your shoe.
Three and two on Cardenas. Castro on deck. Here it is. Pops it up left side, and it's Jed Lowry. Two outs. Another note as we preview the Rangers and the A's a little later. The A's are in first place for the first time since March 29th before most of baseball had even started. Remember, they split that series in Japan, two games against the Mariners. This is the first time they've been back in first place. Incredible. Rookie AJ Griffin is 7-1, and he'll face Ryan Dempster.
Well, if Starlin Castro would take a pitch or two in this at bat, I think Tony is going to try to steal third base. Even though there's two outs in the inning, he's getting a lot of leeway from the Astros middle infielders. Should be able to get a big lead out there at second.
There he goes. And he's got it. His 30th steal of the year without a throw.
Well, you almost have to have one of your middle infielders positioned close to the bag at second, like a first baseman holding on a runner at first, when Campana and some of the other premier base stealers in the game are out there at second base. You try to position yourself in a normal position at short and second, he's going to take off for third.
Thank you.
Chopped to Green at second. Inning over. Campana stranded at third. 1-1 at the end of three.
Monopoly at McDonald's is back with the 20th edition.
Oh,
and more prizes than ever.
I just won $50.
What?
I have never won anything in my life. This is huge. How many people actually win this thing? And I, Monica Roxanne Warden, just won $50.
With the chance to win a card, cash, and 1 in 4 odds at great prizes like your favorite foods. That special feeling is actually pretty typical.
Monica, no, you didn't win $50. You won $500.
The simple joy of more to celebrate.
Let's say you need to take care of legal matters. Wouldn't it be nice if there was an easier, less expensive option than using a traditional lawyer? Well, LegalZoom came up with a better way. We took the best of the old and combined it with modern technology. Together, you get quality services on your terms with total customer support. LegalZoom documents have been accepted in all 50 states, and they're backed by a 100% satisfaction guarantee. So go to LegalZoom.com today and see for yourself. It's law that just makes sense.
So anyway, I've been to a lot of places. You know, I've helped a lot of people, save a lot of money. But today, things have been a little strange.
Meep, meep.
Meep, meep. What a strange place.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
How much does it cost to cut an energy bill down to size? Or get the yard ready for cool weather? The answer? A lot less. The Great American Fix-Up is going on now, with new projects every week and big savings every day. So you can do what needs to be done today. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Right now, Owens Corning EcoTouch Attic Insulation is only $11.87 a roll.
Bottom third in the Astros order. They, I guess, saved their best baseball for the end of the year. They've won five of their last six. Season series on the line today. Each team winning 7 of the first 14. And a 1-1 count on Brandon Laird. Well, Brandon Laird went to high school, La Quinta High, with Cubs third baseman Ian Stewart. Southern California.
Good to see Ian Stewart in the clubhouse before the ball game today. It's been a while since we've seen him around the ballpark. Back renewing acquaintances with some of his teammates. Well, he continues to rehab from that wrist surgery.
Interesting to see what the Cubs do over the winter at that position. Stewart coming back from injury. Kind of a lost season for him. Luis Valbuena, Josh Vitters, and anybody else who might be on the free agent or trade market. A lot of those conversations, though, will take place over the next few days, as I'm sure the Cubs have some ideas. Look at that free agent list. Record just couldn't hang on to it. That turned a foul tip and a strikeout into a foul ball.
Well, obviously no way to adjust that quickly from a catcher. I mean, contact is made about 3 feet in front of your glove. That one was just fouled right over the top of the mitt into the chest protector of John Tumpain behind home plate.
Good changeup. Hey, Cub fans, make sure you check out our WGN Baseball blog. It's brought to you by Jeff Vukovic, nationwide agent serving the area for 33 years. Contact Jeff at jeffvuk.com. Nationwide is on your side. I have a post on the final game of the year as we start to look ahead to 2013.
Start him young.
Also a link to our final podcast of the season. Big swing and a miss by Paredes. We need to update our photo, I think. I think that was taken our first year here, 05. Paredes strikes out.
I think that I used my high school yearbook picture and just airbrush a WGN shirt on it. That's back when I had some hair.
But it doesn't look like you, though. Now. I want it to look like you now. Gonzalez lines out to Brett Jackson, and the first 1-2-3 for Travis Wood. Still deadlocked in one.
The official beer of NFL fans who do whatever it takes. Here we go.
What sounds good for lunch?
You know, beef and cheese.
Yeah. With bacon. Portobello mushrooms, all hot and melty. So, Wendy's?
Wendy's, definitely. Let's go.
What's that?
Leave ordinary behind with Wendy's new Bacon Portobello Melt. Applewood smoked bacon, rich portobellas, and a melty cheddar sauce. Unleashing the power of the melt. That's Wendy's way.
Now that's better.
Do not fall asleep at a sleepover. Lesson learned.
He needs Ragu.
The long day of childhood calls for America's favorite pasta sauce.
Like, I was at this club last week called Chili's, and I met this smoking guy.
Tell me everything.
30 Rock, tonight at 11 East, 8 West on WGN America.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
Let's take a look at our Nissan drive of the game. It came leading off the second inning. Brian LaHare with his 16th home run of the season. RBI number 39. A drive deep into the bleachers in left field. Get to your Nissan dealer for special offers. Nissan, innovation that excites. Visit ChooseNissan.com.
And he will lead it off, as he did in the second with that home run.
I like it. He misspelled school, though. It's S-K-U-L.
Waves at a fastball. Off of third, Dominguez and Jed Lowry. Lowry has it in foul ground. The 28th annual Cubs convention takes place at the Sheraton Chicago and Hotel and Towers on January 18th, 19th, and 20th, 2013. Rooms are available now by calling the Sheraton at 800-233-4100 and asking for the Cubs convention rate. Weekend passes go on sale in early November, and for more info, go to Cubs.com. Curve missed on Dave Sappel. That heater is in there. It's 1-1.
Dave Sappel's been a real nice surprise here at the end of the season, getting a lot of playing time. Showing surprising power, hit a couple of home runs on that last road trip, one in Colorado, one in Arizona.
Two and two. The middle, kicks off the mound, backhanded by Green, throw to first. No, he's safe. Infield single, Dave Sappelt.
Nice play just to get to that ball from Tyler Green. Took a couple of extra steps to find the grip on the baseball, and the one hopper to Laird over at first base. Just too late to get a hustling Dave Sappelt. Just didn't have much of a grip on the baseball that time. Kind of threw a one-hop changeup over to first base.
We've seen so many rookies, position players, pitchers. Cubs have used a franchise record 53 guys this season. And in some cases there have been a lot of struggles for guys their first time around. But I think about Anthony Rizzo and how much he scuffled last year with the Padres. Everything changed this year. And I talked to him yesterday, said validated, you know, his thoughts that he could play and thrive at this level. Think about Carlos Marmol, Bob. When he made his big league debut, he was a very erratic starting pitcher, and it did not go well. And he would end up becoming the Cubs' closer. So then you look at a Josh Bitters, a Brett Jackson, some of the Cubs' young pitchers. Just because they're struggling now doesn't mean in 3 or 4 years they won't be, who knows, all-star caliber players.
Well, you hope they all use this as a very valuable learning tool. What do I need to do to get better? What do I need to do to excel at this level? You mentioned Anthony Rizzo completely retooled his swing. Carlos Marmol became a different pitcher. And if you're going to survive at the major league level, you're going to have to make those adjustments and become a more consistent player in all aspects of the game.
Shallow right and a base hit.
Hey fans, stay tuned for the seventh inning stretch brought to you by Captain Morgan. Raise your glass, always in moderation, to life, love, and loot. And as is our tradition here at Wrigley Field on the final game of the regular season, the Cubs grounds crew gonna lead the crowd here at Wrigley and take me out to the ball game.
Two on, one out for Jackson.
I hope they take off their muddy boots and stuff before they come up here to the booth.
Yeah.
actually,
no, they actually do it right from the field.
Yeah, right from the field. From their home.
Backdoor curve missed wide. Good rip at that one. One ball, one strike.
Boy, those off-speed pitches up in the zone as a Leo DeRocher fan taking in the action here. Astros Leo DeRocher. Yeah, you see those off-speed pitches up in the zone. For whatever reason, optically, you recognize them much quicker than when those off-speed pitches are down in the zone. Brett Jackson recognized that. High off-speed pitch, fouled it straight back.
And Leo finished his managerial career with the Astros the end of 72 and then all of 1973 after managing the Cubs from 66 to 72. Two and two. Not sure if Adam Dunn will play tonight for the White Sox, but he's one strikeout away from tying the all-time single season record. 222 punchouts. Mark Reynolds with 223 in 09.
Oh, nice. I like it. Thanks, Mark. Mark Stenzel doing a little extra work down there to tidy up the hair and take the gray out of the mustache.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Yeah, but we're wearing ties. I don't know if I like that. That might give somebody an idea. Three and two on Jackson.
Yeah, normally you might think about starting both runners here with one out, full count on Brett Jackson, but because he swings and misses so often, real danger of running into a strike him out, throw him out, double play.
Two outside to load him up. Doug Brocale is out.
Is this Doug Brocale's first appearance in the Bizarro World Series?
I think it is.
Yeah, we haven't seen him make a trip to the mound yet. He was probably resting up from that series in Houston earlier when he made one per inning.
Anthony Recker fouls off. Well, with the bases loaded on Sunday, he got the start against Arizona. He got hit by a pitch with the bases loaded, and that provided the game-winning run. 2-1. Sapelt just to dance out of the way. He was in foul ground, so if that ball had hit him, he would not have been called out. That's why guys take their lead down there in foul territory. Jose Valdez and Fernando Abad. The 3-2, ball four. So a record for the second time in a week where the bases loaded. Picks up a go-ahead RBI. It's 2-1.
Well, it's picture-perfect example of pitching scared. Gonzalez just looked like he was afraid to throw a strike with the bases loaded. The last pitch was a changeup in the dirt. Just trying to pitch completely away from contact there. Good patient at bat by Anthony Recker to take the walk.
One and oh on Travis Wood. Hit in the left. Bitters scores. Brett Jackson will score as Maxwell had some issues with it. And it's 4-1. Wood just doubled his RBI total for the season, knocking in a pair.
Well, there have been a lot of games this year where Travis Wood gave Dale Swain the best at bats when he was pitching and batting ninth. Comes through again here. Base hit through that left side. Drive in a couple more.
First and second. Still only one out. Be it for Gonzalez. It will be Abad coming on to face Tony Campana. 4-1 Cubs.
This happy couple used Capital One Venture Miles for their destination wedding. Double miles you can actually use.
But with those single mile travel cards.
Blacked out, but I'm a bridesmaid.
X marks the spot she'll never sit.
But I bought a dress.
A toast.
To the Capital One Venture card. Fly any airline, any flight, any time. Double miles you can actually use. What a coincidence.
What's in your wallet? Watch the elbows, ladies.
How much does it cost to cut an energy bill down to size? Or get the yard ready for cool weather? The answer? A lot less. The Great American Fix-Up is going on now. With new projects every week and big savings every day. So you can do what needs to be done today. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Right now, Owens Corning EcoTouch Attic Insulation is only $11.87 a roll.
This is Rudy. His morning starts with arthritis pain and two pills.
Afternoon's overhaul starts with more pain, more pills. Triple checking hydraulics, the evening brings more pain, so back to more pills. Almost done when, hang on, Stan's doctor recommended Aleve. It can keep pain away all day with fewer pills than Tylenol. This is Rudy, who switched to Aleve and two pills for a day free of pain. And get the all-day pain relief of Aleve in liquid gels.
Fernando Abad, a left-hander, had been working as a starter, recently dealt with a strained right oblique. And since he became a starter, he has made six consecutive starts. They've all been losses. So he'll pitch in relief. Well, he had worked 30 other times earlier this season. And at the end of the year, we want to give a shout out and a special thanks to Bridget Gonzalez and Jeanette Rivera Rosa from our WGN production office. They work so hard behind the scenes, and we want to acknowledge their efforts here today.
Yeah, Bridget probably works a lot harder than she needs to just because of all the issues I dump in her lap on a regular basis. Thank you, Bridget.
So Campana with two on, one out, three runs in for the Cubs, and a called strike.
And just in case you were wondering, Abad, spelled backwards, is Dabba.
Swinging bunt, and they get him.
It's a new era at Wrigley Field. Be part of it with Vineline, the official magazine of the Chicago Cubs. Vineline gives you insider access to the best of the Cubs past, present, and future. Subscriptions start at just $29.95. To subscribe, visit cubs.com/Vineline. You can also pick up the latest issue at the Cubs store across from Wrigley Field or at select newsstand locations.
From the windup to Adrian Cardenas, blowing outside on a breaker. Called strike, 2-1. And a nice tweet from Sam Swan, who watches us all the time on WGN America in New Mexico. Thanks for the nice note, Sam. 3-1 pitch at the knees on a fastball, 3-2. Loaded up again. Three walks in the inning. So Tony DeFrancesco making another change. We'll be back.
Still. Wait, that's not enough buildup.
And?
Five America, because we're giving you great comedy 5 days a week.
5 days a week.
5 days a week.
Why, that deserves
the highest of fives.
So when you think America, think five.
Come on, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That's great comedy.
Give me what? Five.
5 days a week.
Freeze frame high five.
All week long, right here on WGN America.
Not leave a brother hanging.
From their hermetically sealed press box, we want to thank Jason Carr, Peter Chase, and Dusty Harrington, left to right. The Cubs media relations staff, and we rely very heavily on them for all our great information. Job well done. Jose Valdez, as the Astros are matching up here in the fourth.
They've already clinched the Bizarro World Series. I don't understand this, but like you said, Tony's managing quite possibly his last game at the major league level. He's going to get his money's worth.
So here's Castro. Bases loaded. Three in. Cubs lead 4-1. And a called strike. Adam Dunn not in the White Sox starting lineup tonight at Cleveland.
Starlin would really like to pick up some of these runners here. He's 0-for-6 this season with the bases loaded. Good numbers in almost every other category. Still looking for his first knock of the bases loaded.
That one off the end of the bat, and Maxwell will make the catch to end the inning. Cubs get three and lead 4-1. I wish that I could have this moment for life.
Imagine if your heart could be free to find exactly what it's looking for. eHarmony gets to know you better to match you better. Start today free.
Those surprising little things she does still make you take notice. There are a million reasons why. But your erectile dysfunction? That could be a question of blood flow. Cialis for daily use helps you be ready anytime the moment's right. You can be more confident in your ability to be ready. And the same Cialis is the only daily ED tablet approved to treat ED and symptoms of BPH, like needing to go frequently or urgently. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions and medications and ask if your heart is healthy enough for sexual activity. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Do not drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease or loss in hearing or vision, or if you have any allergic reactions, such as rash, hives, swelling of the lips, tongue, or throat, or difficulty breathing or swallowing, stop taking Cialis and get medical help right away. Ask your doctor about Cialis for daily use and a 30-tablet free trial.
Hey, we want to thank Wrigleyville Rooftops. And a reminder, they have premier seating for up to 200 guests, corporate gatherings, family reunions, bachelor, bachelorette parties. You can call 773-248-ROOF. Go to WrigleyvilleRooftops.com for more info. Anthony Recker helping the Cubs get the lead.
Uh-oh. Just say, yes, dear. You're right. I'm sorry. Don't even try to think of an argument. Just, yes, dear, you're right. I'm sorry.
How about just listen?
Yeah. Nod your head. There you go. When they get one hand out and start counting fingers, you know you're in trouble. There was that time last Thursday I asked you to go to the dry cleaners. Then on Friday you forgot to pick up the kids at school. Yes, dear. You're right. I'm sorry.
I think that look he had said that, though, didn't it?
Now, don't even get me started on the Bears game Monday night. Had all the guys over. You didn't clean up after yourself.
Swing and a miss on a cutter.
Oh, man. Whew. He'd rather get in a fight with Mike Tyson right now than listen to that.
Strike three. The fifth inning is brought to you by Fifth Third Bank, the Curious Bank. Member FDIC.
Might be the fifth round.
Outside to Jed Lowry.
I told you all summer I wanted to go to a Cubs game, and you don't take me until the last game of the season. I've had this hat all summer.
He said, you're right.
Yes, dear. You're right.
I'm sorry. Campana in left. Backpedaling, he has it. Chip in Lancaster, PA, watching us. Cub fan since 1984. Contacted us on Twitter. Just foul through the Cubs bullpen.
The last day of the regular season for teams that are out of playoff contention, you always see some odd things. And I'm sure if you were over in the visiting clubhouse after the ball game today, maybe even the home clubhouse, you'd see some guys foregoing the shower in order to get in the cab and get to the airport and quickly catch their flights back home. One year I was with the Giants, we finished in Cincinnati, and Matt Williams and Kurt Manwaring actually left the ballpark in their uniforms, changed in the cab on the way to the airport.
That's
trying to catch
good.
A flight back home.
The thing is, if you're a big leaguer and you're wearing your uniform, nobody would believe it's an
yeah.
actual major leaguer.
He's come from a costume party or something.
Well, it looks like Matt Williams. Well, it can't be because he's wearing a Giants uniform.
There's no way he would wear a Giants uniform on the street. But it happens. You mentioned a lot of boxes, a lot of tape, a lot of things being arranged to head elsewhere after the ball game today. That's one time it's a real advantage to live in your home city.
Yeah.
You don't have to pack anything up the last day of the season. You can come back to the ballpark tomorrow and pick it up.
We finally found the right pictures. And a reminder to check out our weekly podcast, WGNTV.com.
Welcome to Bud Light Fantasy Football, where every bottle is a player.
My Bud Light threw for 4 TDs.
Draft players using codes on specially marked bottles of Bud Light.
Mine won the game with a 60-yard field goal.
Manage your team at BudLight.com/FFL.
My Bud Light fumbled at the 3-yard line.
My Bud Light extended my winning streak.
When Bud Light is on your roster, every game is a win.
My Bud Light made him cry.
Bud Light Fantasy Football. Start building your team today.
Just down the street, there's a hardware store with great tools, products,
and expert advice.
We've got everything you need.
Because we know the community.
And we know our customers.
So next time you have a home improvement project,
drop by
your local True Value hardware store. True Value.
Start right.
Start here. Right now, we've got everything you need for that all-important fall cleanup. So hurry in today.
When you pay too much for cable, you feel dejected. When you feel dejected, you need some comfort. When you need some comfort, you make a surprise visit home. When you make a surprise visit home, you discover something new about your parents. When you discover something new about your parents, you speed off with tears in your eyes. And when you speed off with tears in your eyes, you drive into a pizzeria that makes great baked ziti. Don't drive into a pizzeria that makes great baked ziti. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
When you get heartburn, it's too late for Prilosec. It takes at least 24 hours for full effect. But it's never too late for Zantac. Its fast-release acid blockers relieve heartburn in as little as 30 minutes. No pill works faster. When heartburn strikes, try Zantac.
Your favorite comedies, sports, and movies, all on WGN America.
Third Bank, the curious bank, member FDIC.
Lester Strode, the Cubs bullpen coach, and somebody decided to find an old baseball card from when he was a coach at Single A Winston-Salem in 1992 in the Cubs minor league system. That's tapped foul by Brian LaHare.
For Lester Strode, this is his 24th season as a member of the Cubs organization. I would imagine Lester has to remind the guys in the bullpen of this, but when he pitched at Kentucky State University, he two different times he led the NAIA in strikeouts. Left-hander, hard throwing left-hander. The 2012 Chicago Cubs baseball season on WGN TV is brought to you by Bud Light Limerita, the ready-to-drink margarita with a refreshing twist of Bud Light Lime.
Two tutela hairs outside. Brian and Louise are watching from Worcester, Mass., the home of Brian LaHare. Sharply hit ground ball. Tyler Green gets the out. Great to see Piper Meade and Jamie King. And it's Piper's mom in the middle. They're from Cubs marketing. They've got good seats right behind the dugout.
They must know somebody.
They must know somebody. Do a great job in Cubs marketing.
And then I wanted to relay a message to Dusty Baker from our media dining room chef Robert Chamberlain and his wife Ingrid. They wanted to wish Dusty get well wishes and good luck in the postseason.
Again, the Reds 97 wins, tied with the Nationals going into the final day of the season for the best record in baseball. Dave Sapelt. Shallow left and caught by Jed Lowry. New in 2012 is Cubs Authentics, the premier outlet for special MLB authenticated Cubs memorabilia, from game used balls, bases, and jerseys to autographed bats and photos. Cubs Authentics has the most exclusive Cubs memorabilia. Visit the Wrigley Field Concourse, the Cubs store, or email CubsAuthentics@Cubs.com for all your Cubs memorabilia needs. 1-0 on Josh Bitters. He singled and scored in the fourth, walked and stole a base in the second. Lowry gets the out. Cubs go down quietly but lead 4-1.
WGN.
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 WGN America.
WGN America.
Where the fans are in charge. This is WGN America, home to the biggest shows on television.
Nice. Looks like WGN America filled out in all the right places.
You're good, WGN America. You're very good.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch.
Hey, guys.
Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
This is Rudy. His morning starts with arthritis pain and two pills. Afternoon's overhaul starts with more pain, more pills. Triple checking hydraulics, the evening brings more pain, so back to more pills. Almost done when, hang on, Stan's doctor recommended Aleve. It can keep pain away all day with fewer pills than Tylenol. This is Rudy, who switched to Aleve and two pills for a day free of pain. And get the all-day pain relief of Aleve in liquid gels.
Attention, this is a consumer health alert. Medical journals are reporting some metal-on-metal hip replacements are linked to implant failures, metallosis, cobalt toxicity, metal poisoning, pseudotumors, and other serious injuries. Some hip replacement devices have even been recalled. If you've had a metal-on-metal hip replacement, you need to call this number immediately. 1-800-800-8815. That's 1-800-800-8815. Protect your rights. Call 1-800-800-8815 right now.
Hey, Chicagoland viewers, if you want to wear what the Cubs are wearing, then text VINE to 88019 right now for your chance to win an authentic game-worn jersey from the Cubs. And be sure to go to Cubs.com/authentics for more authentic Cubs memorabilia.
Cubs lead 4-1. Ground ball right to Starlin Castro as he gets Justin Maxwell for the out. Cub fans, be sure to like the Cubs on the official Chicago Cubs Facebook page at facebook.com/Cubs and follow the official @Cubs Twitter handle for the latest team news, updates, photos, sweepstakes, and more. All right, partner, we got a tweet from Jim Weihofen. To our @LennonBob Twitter handle. Ever thought about switching with Pat and Keith for a game or at least an inning? No, but we're going to do it. So last game of the season.
Since you ask.
The bottom of the sixth, we're going to switch with the radio guys. Nice dig by LaHare. Let's step aside and see what's coming up on WGN.
WGN America is, wait for it, the home of the superfan. Join the How I Met Your Mother conversation now at facebook.com/meetatmclarens.
Well, they used to do it. Harry used to go back and forth. So why not? We'll have a little fun on the final day. We will go make people wonder on the radio who in the world is talking. Deep to center, Brandon Barnes.